Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Johnson. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 5th of July. India's COVID vaccination platform Covin to be made open source for all nations, says PM Modi. Activists hold anti-Pakistan protests in Geneva, raise concern over attacks on journalists. And Afghans worry about security amid US troop withdrawal. And now for all the details. Emphasizing the importance of technology in the fight against the COVID-19 pandemic, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi at the Covin Global Conclave on Monday announced that India's COVID vaccination platform Covin is being prepared to be made open source, available to any country interested in the technology. He also pointed out that vaccination is the best hope for humanity to emerge successfully from the COVID-19 pandemic.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday announced that the COVID vaccination platform Covin was being made open source, emphasizing the importance of technology in the fight against the COVID-19 pandemic at the Covin Global Conclave held virtually. About 50 countries had expressed interest in the Covin app for their vaccination drive. Covin was developed in India as the central IT system for strategizing, implementing, monitoring and evaluating COVID-19 vaccination across the country. PM Modi also pointed out that vaccination is the best hope for humanity to emerge successfully from the COVID-19 pandemic.
Indian civilization considers the whole world as one family. The pandemic has made many people realize the fundamental truth of this philosophy. That is why our technology platform for COVID vaccination, the platform we call Covin, is being prepared to be made open source.
Meanwhile, India reopened stadiums, adventure sports and eased other localized restrictions on Monday after months of lockdown in a gradual reopening after the deadly second wave of coronavirus prompted shutdowns. Enthusiastic players were seen thronging the R.K. Khanna Tennis Stadium in the Indian capital, New Delhi. Picturesque Indian Kashmir opened whitewater rafting, one of the first adventure sports to reopen after the second wave. In the southern part of the country, Karnataka state allowed opening up of malls and places of worship on Monday as cases waned in one of the worst affected states. Uttar Pradesh state in northern India also allowed the reopening of stadiums, parks and gyms. India reported 39,796 new COVID-19 cases in the last 24 hours, Health Ministry data showed on Friday, with active cases at 482,071.
In news from Pakistan, at the rally of the multi-party opposition alliance in Swat on Sunday, opposition leader Shehbaz Sharif took a jibe at Prime Minister Imran Khan's government for failing to deliver its promise, saying he left no stone unturned in destroying the people of Pakistan.
Opposition PMLN Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz leader Shahbaz Sharif on Sunday once again took a jibe against Prime Minister Imran Khan and said that he left no stone unturned in destroying the people of Pakistan. Addressing a rally of the multi-party opposition alliance Pakistan Democratic Movement in Swat, Shahbaz said ever since Khan's PTI-led government took over, the country has been going through historical poverty and the country has been brought to the brink of disaster.
तो मैं आपको ये कहने आया हूं कि मेरी बात सुन लो आज गौर से कि अगर आपने इस हुकूमत का आपने इस हुकूमत का अपने वोट की ताकत से खात्मा ना किया तो यकीन कर लें कि पाकिस्तान को तबाही की दहाने पहुंचा चुके हैं फिर कोई बचाने वाला नहीं होगा
Shahbaz also lauded the previous PMLN-led government and cited comparative statistics, adding that the old Pakistan was much better than the Naya or New Pakistan. Earlier this month, local media in Pakistan reported the worsening state of country's energy crisis as the country was facing an electricity shortfall of somewhere between 7,000 and 8,000 megawatts. Due to the power crisis, long hours of load shedding are also taking place in several cities.
Moving on, political activists recently staged a protest outside the UNHRC building in Geneva against human rights violations and restrictions on freedom of expression by Pakistan in its illegally occupied territories. They highlighted Islamabad misuses draconian laws against activists and journalists to muzzle the dissent and deny access to information.
Political activists from Pakistan-administered Kashmir recently held an anti-Pakistan protest outside the UNHRC building in Geneva against human rights violations, restrictions on freedom of expression in illegally occupied territories ruled by Islamabad. The protesters urged the United Nations to intervene to stop enforced disappearances of ethnic minorities by the Pakistani state and its forces, and misuse of draconian laws against activists and journalists to muzzle dissent and deny access to information. They said only those who have fallen in line with the government's versions are safe in the region, while others are living constantly under an ever-expanding shadow of fear.
दूसरा यूनाइटेड नेशन ह्यूमन राइट्स काउंसिल को ये कहना था कि आप मुदाखलत करें और पाकिस्तान को प्रेशराइज करें कि वो ऐसे ड्रैकोनियन लॉज और ये जो अनडेमोक्रेटिक प्रैक्टिसेस हैं टू सुप्रेस द वॉइसेस ऑफ द सिविल सोसाइटी इसको चेंज करें. ये बिहेवियर कम अज कम 21st सेंचुरी में टोटली अनएक्सेप्टेबल है.
The political activist also held a conference in Geneva to apprise former judges and human rights defenders of the situation. Although Pakistan's government insists it supports freedom of speech, human rights groups often accuse Pakistan's military and its agencies of harassing and attacking journalists.
In news from Afghanistan, Kabul residents have expressed concern that they fear the security situation in Afghanistan would worsen after the United States pulled out troops from the main Bagram military base last Friday. The development came as violence has risen sharply around the country and peace talks in Doha have failed to make significant progress.
Residents in Afghanistan's capital Kabul have expressed concern after US forces handed over the main Bagram military base and pulled troops, saying they fear the security situation in the country would worsen. Security experts have said despite the surge in ongoing violence, it was unlikely that the Taliban could take power as they would not be accepted by the people. For ordinary Afghans, the uncertainties are worrying. The handover of the Bagram base to the Afghan government was part of a 2019 agreement with the Taliban, which includes withdrawal of all US forces after a two-decade war. It came as violence has risen sharply around the country, and peace talks in Doha have failed to make significant progress.
والا تشویش خود تنها از من تمام افغانستان تشویش به ای دارن که اگر نیروهای امریکایی از افغانستان خارج شوه طالبان و افغانستان تصرف میکنه و هیچ مردم افغانستان هیچ فرد افغان از طالبان رضایت کامل نداره دیگه مشکلات همینجاست که از روزی که آوازه و دروازه شده به کاروبار مردم بسیار لکمه وارد شده و همچنان تشویش مردم بسیار زیاد است
طالبان با زور به در افغانستان کیو را قبول میکنه مردم افغانستان اونا را قبول نمیکنه بنان همه جبهات جور میشه این میلی ببین در ما در تمام ولایت مردم بازیت طالبان خستان تپان گرفتن دیگه
دی طالبان هاز لانچد ا ویو اف افنسیوز اکراس دی کانتری پارتیکولرلی ان دی نورث آوت سایڈ اف دیر سادرن سترونگ هولدز ریپورٹس سجیسٹ ان دی لاسٹ 2 منتھس ایٹ لیسٹ 120 ڈسٹرکٹس ہیو فالن ٹو دی انسرجنٹ گروپ
ان نیوز فرام بنگلہ دیش The coronavirus infections have been rising in Bangladesh since last month. Bangladesh on Sunday recorded the highest single-day deaths from COVID-19 at 153, the highest single-day toll since the pandemic began as health officials warned that the high infection rate could create a shortage of medical oxygen supply.
Bangladesh on Sunday recorded the highest single day deaths from COVID-19 at 153, bringing the overall death toll to 15,065, said the country's Directorate General of Health Services. This is the highest single day toll since the pandemic began, as the health officials warned that the high infection rate could create a shortage of medical oxygen supply. According to the official data, 8,661 more confirmed cases were recorded in the Asian country, raising the total tally to 944,917. The total number of recovered COVID-19 patients in the country has risen to 833,897. To curb the virus transmission, Bangladesh last Thursday entered a one-week strict COVID-19 lockdown, and army personnel have been deployed to patrol alongside civilian forces to maintain law and order. Bangladesh recorded the highest daily new cases at 8,822 on June 30. Meanwhile, since the first detection of the Delta variant in April this year, the rate of infection by this variant started rising. The Institute of Epidemiology, Disease Control and Research, a Bangladesh government research institute under the Ministry of Health, said they have found dominance of Delta variant among the recent cases of COVID-19.
Youth from border villages of India's Jammu and Kashmir thronged in large numbers for a police recruitment drive in the Union Territory's Baramulla district on Sunday. Those who got selected would be trained to stop infiltration bids and cross-border drugs and weapons smuggling.
Youths from border villages of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir thronged a recruitment drive conducted by the police for its special border battalion on Sunday. The border battalion of Jammu and Kashmir police is formed with the special purpose of inclusivity, and the selected youths will be trained to stop infiltration bids and cross-border drugs and weapons smuggling. Recruitment drives like these help the youth in serving the nation and cementing faith in security forces, besides providing employment opportunities.
In fact, ये augment करेगा J&K police को border areas में जो लोग रहते हैं उनकी representation थोड़ी कम थी J&K force में. So government has decided कि वो exclusively इन लोगों को recruitment देगा जो border areas में बहुत सारी इनको difficulties है. So it's a sort of help to those border people.
हम इसीलिए हम police में भर्ती होना चाहते हैं कि हम देश की सेवा करें. कोई भी हमारे देश में घुसपैठिए कोई भी आ सकते हैं, क्योंकि हम इसको अंदर आना नहीं देंगे अपने देश से. अपने देश में सुरक्षित रखने की मतलब हमारे यही चिंता है.
कश्मीर इज अ मुस्लिम मेजोरिटी रीजन एट द हार्ट ऑफ डेकेड्स ऑफ होस्टिलिटी बिटवीन इंडिया एंड पाकिस्तान. इंडिया एक्यूजेस पाकिस्तान ऑफ सपोर्टिंग मिलिटेंसी इन द एरिया. पाकिस्तान डिनाइज द चार्ज, सेइंग देयर सपोर्ट इज ओनली मोरल एंड नॉट फाइनेंशियल और लॉजिस्टिकल.
An idol maker in India's East and West Bengal state finds pride in exporting handmade idols of Hindu warrior goddess Durga, made from fiberglass, to foreign countries amid the COVID-19 pandemic. An idol maker in India's East and West Bengal state has exported fiberglass idols of Hindu warrior goddess Durga to foreign countries, becoming the first artisan in the region to send his artwork overseas amid the COVID-19 outbreak. Idol maker Mintu Pal, who hails from Kolkata city, said despite the pandemic, he received two orders from New Jersey and Berlin each, which will be priced at around $2,000.
Har saal hamare idhar Kolkata Kumartoli se videshon mein fiber glass ka Durga murti jaate hai. Is saal bhi maine ko do order mila hai, ek New Jersey chala gaya USA aur ek to Berlin jayega abhi. जाने के लिए तैयार है. ये टोटल फाइबर ग्लास का बना हुआ है और इसका कॉस्ट कम से कम 1.5 लाख के ऊपर ही आता है.
Artisans in West Bengal state are famous for creating larger than life idols of Hindu warrior goddesses that are worshipped during the grand Hindu festival of Durga Puja or festival dedicated to the goddess. However, like all other industries, the pandemic has stung the business of the artisans of Kolkata as well. Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.